All right, there I am. All right, well, we can get started here. We're doing some Star Citizen, and go to electronic access if you want to do some dogfighting. We're going to use our Vanguard. We're hoping we still have the Vanguard. It's been a little while. You rent the ships here, so I'm going to do a spectrum match, public match. That's how you get your rental equipment credits. And I do have the Aegis showing there. Let's go ahead and do a squadron match, squadron battle. Click launch. And it looks like we found a match. That was quick. Let's see if anybody's online too. We're going to, from the looks of it, they're all offline. Joining in here on the Broken Moon. Go ahead and start the recording for this. Alright, welcome back everybody. This is PapaSean. We're going to do a recording with some Vanguard. The squadron battle. It'll be at the Broken Moon. That's hot. Some hot tea there. Alright, once we load up, we've got it's 8 missiles. And we've got the 4 standard laser guns with an additional level 3 gun. I took away the Gatling. I find that I'm more of a laser guy myself. And I like the fast attack speed with the lasers. You know, it reaches the target much, much faster than if you were to use a Gatling gun and have to time out the bullets a bit. That, and I seem to have misplaced it, so I'll have to wait till I get a new Vanguard before I go equipping that gun back on there. So, one of the most disconcerting things about the Vanguard is the reduction in radar systems that you have on this. Alright, so it looks like the match has been going for about 9 minutes. So normally you'd have a second player in the ship with you. And they would target with their turret as well as scan on the radar systems. Alright, so I'm barely picking up anybody. But we'll lock onto this guy once we come into range. Man, he took off. I guess we'll go after these two turkeys, huh? Got us, but I think we got him too.
Stand by for reintegration. Warning. You are approaching the simulation boundary.
Systems green. Begin scan. Contact.
Missile. like a hornet there. Ouch.
Shields recharging. Proximity alert.
That was my bad for stopping moving. Got taken out by an Aegis Dynamics Avenger Stalker. Pretty cool ship.
Stand by for reintegration.
Aegis.
See if we can get back into the black here.
Contact.
Stay in the black in case we die. My cookies. Alright, well, I think there was like four or five ships on my tail there. We're two and three. I think we're like fourth on the stat list now. We got 4 minutes to try to turn this around. Alright, let's look for an easy target. Mr. NY Fire is a good one to go after. I'm not seeing him. I'll settle for this turkey. Not a fan of the responsiveness on this big old bird, the Vanguard. Floating all around here. Coming at me. I don't know if it's latency or what. Alright, so this guy wants my nuggets. Take it. Wasn't exactly the best match for us. 2 and 3 didn't give away too many deaths, but 6, 7. Yeah, we're fourth place as far as 13 players. 1366 rec taking it home. Had better matches, but I don't know why. It just felt like the ship was not as responsive that match. I don't know if I got too much running in the background. If it was latency or just they changed the way they feel. Or I could be imagining all of it. Let's hit switch streams. Gonna stop the recording. I'll show the next match in a separate episode. Alright, welcome back everyone. This is PapaSean. We're gonna go ahead and launch another episode of Squadron Battle, this time in a Vanguard. We had been doing quite a few Hornet matches to get to enough rec to buy the Vanguard, rent it for a week. And the way they break it up is it's 7 24-hour periods, so you can play one time a week, and you know, you get 7 weeks out of it if you only do one day of gaming if you're pretty casual. So that's pretty neat. It's not just an ongoing week where you really don't have much advantage unless you're a hardcore gamer. All right, so Squadron Battle is neat. If you're not familiar with it, you pit one or two to like 6, maybe 10 players on each side. And it's just a big team-on-team dogfight, and in the Broken Moon, there's lots of asteroids and rocks cover to go behind. What's neat about this game, too, is you can actually lower your power signature and become invisible to radar. There's some low power consumption ships that make it really hard for them to be found. I find this Aegis ship is, let's see here. Game's starting out. It's a little less responsive. It's a two-seater ship, so it's a bit larger, has quite a few more shields. Alright, so looking at our team, wow, our team outnumbers theirs quite a bit. And you see us topped out at 185 as far as our speed. If I move around a little bit, you can see it's not quite as responsive as, say, a Hornet. They're already firing their missiles.
Contact. Begin scan.
Contact. putting out the damage like I had hoped on that guy. That guy, I think we're being hounded. As for that, going head on head with it. We're doing pretty good as far as score, 29-10.
Stand by for reintegration.
Pop back in. I should have probably not gone head to head with him. The ship seems to die quite a bit in head on collision. Contact. Some missiles there. We're toast. Alright, we took top billing though, 2-2. We're gonna have to see if we get a few more shots in before we get gangbanged by like 5 ships. So coming up with the Hornet, I found it really hard to take on Vanguards, but it seems as a Vanguard, I'm not having as much luck as I've seen other people have with their Vanguards. And it's hard to know when people are actually on you.
Contact.
So I get a rear shield 25%, but that's the only acknowledgement, only knowledge I've got for all my butt. Trying to get back within the firing arcs and get the carpal tunnel over here.
For reintegration.
Not working out so good. Aegis, Madison's activated. Systems, green. Contact. Begin scan.
So Ronus, this guy right here, is their bleeder. He's the one that's been dying a lot on their team. Let's see if we can take advantage of that. Get a few easy kills here.
Thank you.
another Vanguard right there.
This is very slow response on the Vanguard.
You are top billing 5 kills, 6 deaths. Not sure why that is, but it is. You think one of the other players might miss the collisions? I'm gonna have to try a faster ship next time. Not too pleased with the Vanguard. See, that guy was able to get right behind me. Shields recharging. Flare drop. Friendly? Shields recharging. Circles are over them. Yeah, I can't seem to adjust for the. I don't know if it's lag or what, but when the little circle is over, it's a predictive fire.
Stand by for reintegration.
At least on my screen, I'm seeing the predictive circle on the deck.
Systems green.
But it should give you a damage indicator. I'm not seeing that.
Contact.
It's pretty cool. We're top billing. I don't feel like I'm doing a good job. It's hard to believe that I'm actually 7,400 ahead of or 7,000 ahead of the next player. It doesn't feel that way. think I bumped him out of the map. Sometimes when you hit them with missiles, it'll hit them so hard they get knocked contact all the way out. So 6 kills, 8 deaths, but we got top billing 800 or 700, 600, 7,600 damage more. So that's 2,323 wreck. That's like a ship. It's a small ship. So a normal game might be about 1,000, but 2,323, whatever it was. Pretty cool. Alright, well, thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share. It's free to do those things, and I'll let you know about additional content as it's made available. I'm going to keep streaming, and I'll pause this session for the record here so that you can watch the next episode, and I'll catch you next time. Alright, welcome back, everyone. This is PapaSean. We're going to continue to do some Vanguard, see if we can get the feel for this ship. We're going to do some squadron battle, and Broken Moon is the location. Let's see if there's any statements. Alright, just some updates on my ARC videos. Alright. But yeah, check out the channel, subscribe, share, comment. All these things will help me out immensely. You have no idea how much that helps me. So thank you very much if you guys do that, and I appreciate you guys watching. It's free to do all those things. It helps me out with like the search engines, what have you. So we're doing some squadron battle, as I said, Broken Moon. The Vanguard, it's a two-seater ship. The person in the second seat would handle the turret and check the radar, fire missiles, that kind of thing. Or at least lock the missiles.
Contact. Squadron battle initiated.
And I can tell you, I am feeling it. I mean, I've never had somebody in the second seat. I'm not sure they allow that yet, but it definitely would benefit from having somebody in here, because as you see, you can't tell what ship you're facing off with when you target them. And I can switch between the targets. I see the name, but I have no idea what I'm going to face. Whereas in other ships like the Hornet, you'd identify what kind of ship it was. And this is a very heavy ship, so there's a lot of delay as you try to make your turns. You have to kind of predict. So I'm already being attacked by somebody. I have to try to get a kill or two before they gang up on me. Bugging out. I got somebody right on my tail, so let me turn around and see what kind of trouble I can get into. Yeah. my nuggets. Killed by a Mustang Delta. Nice work there, Mr. Tokachu.
Stand by for reintegration.
So let's see if we can target Tokachu and get a revenge kill. Looking for Mr. Tokachu. There's Tokachu. Alright, so if we can manage to kill this guy, we'll get a revenge kill. Mustang Delta and melted me with his ballistic cannon. Wow. Pretty cool. Tokachu. Three kills, zero deaths.
For reintegration.
Head shield under fire. Aegis combat assist. Activate. Systems green. Begin scan. Contact.
See if I can locate that Tokachu again. Go up for another match. There he is.
Contact. Begin scan. Contact.
Bouncing around quite a bit.
Proximity alert. Deck. Shields recharging. Contact. Begin scan. Shields recharging.
So an M50 jump works took me out with a neutron cannon S2. Pretty cool.
Stand by for reintegration.
So if we look at the scorecard, I'm third place. Best of my team, but that's not saying too much. Trying to hit the upward or down thrusters, trying to get around the rock, but watch out where you're at.
Warning.
Aegis.
You are approaching simulation boundary.
Systems. Green. Begin scan. Contact. Contact. Begin scan. Contact. Begin scan.
Friendly fire is not tolerated, so that's what happens, you get kicked out. Well, my rockets were after the guy, and then my friendly flew right into the range of the rockets. But if I click rejoin the launch, whatever, it should put me back into that same match, so let's hope that happens. Because apart from that friendly fire, we were doing fairly decent, at least in the damage department. But you saw that was 1900 damage when my two missiles collided with that guy. Instant kick.
Systems green.
All right, checking it out. Yep, so on top of the losing team, back in the match that I just got kicked out of. Radar still hasn't picked up any targets. And they're right in front of me. Feeling there's an enemy right next to me, and my radar just hasn't. Got him. Got another one. Good since we got back in here, huh? Alright, so they got me, but since I got back in, I got into the green 8-6. Our team is losing pretty hard.
Stand by for reintegration.
But if I can keep that going. That was coming. I kind of swing around and I'm going this way. The rocks are coming right at me and I'm trying to go forward. Nope. Bit it.
Stand by for reintegration.
All right, we got seven. Under that. I thought I made it underneath. Oh, got clipped. Alright, it may not feel like it, but we are third place. Despite all of that
stand
silliness.
By for reintegration.
Aegis, contact assist. Activate. Systems, green. Begin scan. Contact.
And I'm not. There we go. Wasn't moving for a little bit. Neostat. Alright, their big loser is Nova. So if we could find Nova, it's almost like a guaranteed kill, I think.
Contact. Rear shield under fire.
Oh, really? Set's doing pretty decent. 5-2.
Stand by for reintegration.
Wonder why his stats are his score is so low, being 5-2.
Activate. Systems green. Begin scan. Contact.
Need another good run. If we can come in here and splat that guy real quick. I'm shooting this turkey. Toast myself though. Alright, that was coming. That was coming. But that actually brought us almost to first place. We're behind just by about 400 points for damage lead. And we're almost even on kills and deaths. Control the system again here. Not sure why my missiles aren't coming. There they are. Took it to you. You are the leader.
Stand by for reintegration.
1 minute remaining. Tokachu, where are you? Contact.
Contact. Begin scan. Contact.
But we led the board on our blue team, got 16.656 score with 1971 wreck as a loss. That's pretty cool. If you look at the opposing team, they got 1954. It's their highest player's wreck. That's actually the highest. Nice. So even though my team lost, we scored the most wreck, at least I did, by any player in the game. So the Vanguard is definitely a rental equipment credit money maker, but I tell you what, I feel more vulnerable in this thing than I did in the Hornet. Definitely more damage output, so we'll stick with it. All right, well, thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe. I appreciate all the attention on the channel. Helps me out a lot, and it's free to do, so please do that. And I'll catch you guys in some more battles. I'll keep the stream going, and I'll catch you in the next episode. Alright, welcome back. This is PapaSean. We are about to enter into the next squadron battle. Getting a little bit better with the Vanguard here. Still struggling from lack of radar, lack of identifying targets as easily as you can in other ships, say, like the Hornet. The Hornet, you can pick your targets. If you don't want to go against Vanguards, you can target something else, fly out, and a lot quicker to respond to. The Vanguard's a bit more sluggish. You find that if you gain momentum towards one direction, you will continue in that way for quite a while. You have to really get used to using the R and F key for your thrusters. R would pick you up, and then F would bring you down. So use that to dodge all these asteroids out here. If I had a...
contact. Warning.
You are approaching a co-pilot, somebody in the turret.
Systems green.
All right, so just two players in here right now.
Contact. Squadron battle initiated.
Just got started, so others will join in as the game goes. Curious how the one-on-one is. So in the Hornet, I also found that I could do collisions, and it might knock out weapon systems, but I rarely died from the collision. In the Vanguard, it seems if I collide with anything, I'm toast. So gotta watch out for head-on collisions. Use your thrusters to get out of the way of the chicken fights. So we are going head-to-head. So with this, I'm gonna want to try to angle away from the guy. Use my thrusters as we get closer. And I'm just kind of guessing at this. I just do not want to go head-to-head and collide with the guy. And I'll thruster up. Okay, we got another enemy out here with us too now. So we're nearly toast. And we're very unresponsive as we spin out of control right now. Got our rockets off, though. Yeah, so we're kind of a sitting target there. But we were able to get a few missiles off again and some more firepower onto the guy. We got killed by Pikachu again, so let's get in there.
Reintegration.
Their revenge kill.
Systems green. Begin scan. Contact.
All right, there's our Tokachu, but this guy's closer. So we'll see if we can wipe this guy out for lucky. I think Tokachu just bit it. Closer. I'm gonna downward thrust. Getting shot up 25% from behind by Mr. Tuck. No, who is it? Our missiles appear to be offline. You can kind of see in the radar our ship is a bit red from damage. And we're getting beat on by somebody here. So we got Neoset on our team. He's killing it 3-0, and we're at 1-1.
Contact. Begin scan.
Out, but as you can see, we're leading the pack in damage right now with a score of 5-6-5. Yeah, we got 2 kills, 2 deaths. So even though Neosat's got 4 kills and 0 deaths, he's still, for some reason, being scored below me. I personally think you should get more points for longer innings.
Begin scan. contact.
Friendly fire is not tolerated. I just got kicked again. Missiles will get you in trouble, I tell you what. So Neosat was having trouble dying, so I helped him along on that, and then I got kicked. So he'll be joining back in. Should be able to get right back into the game again. So again, so far I would say Hornet is a preferred ship for me, even though the firepower is not there to take on a Vanguard. Might be able to outplay a Vanguard, definitely more maneuverable, nice missile.
Contact. Begin scan.
Yeah, so we were able to get right back in, 3 kills, 2 deaths. Targets have been reported over here. Trying to get to the party, moving a little bit slower than the rest of them. In the asteroid cluster right now. I gotta get out of here before I get taken out.
Contact.
No! Alright, time to eject. I don't get to do this very often. Can't eject. Well, they helped me eject. So we're 5 kills and 3 deaths. And we're second place.
Stand by for reintegration.
Aegis, dinosaurs, activate. Systems, green. Begin scan. Contact. Begin scan. Contact.
Missiles went past him, came back and bit him. Pretty neat. I think there's a bit of lag. They're bouncing around a little bit. Now you see him, now you don't. The missiles found him okay though. Still top billing, 7-4. Not bad. It's probably one of our better games.
Bye.
Even though we killed one of our friends.
You are approaching simulation boundary.
Systems green. Begin scan. Contact.
No, he's a laggy bugger. Kill the guy I wasn't firing at? What's that about? Let's choose a different target. That guy is just way too laggy. Somebody was after my cookies, and they got them too.
But we've solidified our lead. Eight for reintegration. Alright. Using the downward thrust to get around the rocks. It loses the lock like that. I'm trying to shoot the guy. Well, so much for that. Let me see if I can watch out for these rocks. Back everyone, this is PapaSean, and we are playing XCOM 2. Alright, so we got the stream up, recording, we got some indication down here, power at capacity. So we maxed out our power, on-staffed engineer, where's that? So we got two engineers, I'm curious how we address that on-staffed engineer piece. So we go to engineering.
Commander?
Yes. View engineers. We've got two. He's available. Adriana Flores is clearing debris. We've got this person available. So I take it if
what we do you know about these gene therapy clinics, Doctor? They seem like a big draw for the cities right now.
Having worked in one of the facilities, I can tell you firsthand. They do offer a level of medical care unmatched by any previous effort in our history. The aliens have effectively cured all of humanity's greatest ailments. Cancer, malaria, AIDS. The process is relatively simple.
As long as you're compliant.
Yes. The price of admission is acceptance of all Advent policies. For many people, that's hardly a consideration. A minor inconvenience at most.
I'm beginning to see the appeal.
Yeah, they had a lot to say. So, I had a spare engineer, and I went ahead and cleared this debris. It's going to take 20 days to do that. Proving grounds A, clearing alien debris, there's 4. So with that, we've got our engineering armory. We've got 3 wounded, 10 available soldiers. Magnetic weapons in 14 days, that's in the research. Alright, so let's go ahead and figure out. We got to construct the Proving Grounds facility.
The new uniform isn't bad considering, but sometimes I do miss that damn sweater. Commander, you should establish contact with the local resistance network as soon as possible. The aliens are undoubtedly moving forward with their plans.
Excellent. Okay, so Commander, the resistance has heard rumors of the Black Mart in the wilderness near one of our havens, if we scan the area.
Avenger plotting new course.
Alright, so we can check out that black market. Maybe get some weaponry. Let's go ahead and search. Alien
alien debris is cleared. Let's go to view the room.
Maximum power consumption reached. Power relay construction initiated.
Carry on. Let's get back to the bridge. Alright, so we got one day remaining on Black Market. Establishing a secure line. The Black Market has been successfully located, Commander. They seem willing to provide some material support in exchange for intel. They're also eager to buy any unused items we can spare.
The market is open.
Okay. Well, I don't know that I want to sell my inventory, but let's see what they've got. I got alien alloys. Probably want to keep those. Yeah. They want alien cores. We got 30 of those. Let's go ahead and not worry about selling our stuff. What if we were to buy intel? We've got 126 intel. Wouldn't hurt to have another grenadier. Rush research. Like I'm working on the magnetic weapons right now. Think, maybe I'm not. Let's go ahead and buy this for 30 intel. I'd like to have magnetic weapons. I don't really care about the Stone Lancer research so much. It's going to cost 90 intel for this grenadier, but you know what? I would like to have a nice grenadier. Black market's used up. Let's hope we didn't need that intel. Alright, so that's the Black Market on XCOM 2. Pretty cool. Alright, so now that we purchased from the Black Market, let's go ahead and take a look at the make contact.
Commander,
option.
As of right now, we don't have enough intel to get a solid bearing on the local resistance forces in that area.
How funny is that? I just spent up all my intel. Alright, so how do we get more intel, you wonder, huh? Well, we got a Black Market we can go to.
Avenger plotting new course.
Go to those resources, I think. The resistance has detected activity of interest here. The Avenger scans the area, XCOM investigate the reports. Making contact one day. Let's go ahead and wait the day.
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
Okay.
Course for East Asia.
I'm gonna go ahead and make the contact. I'm bouncing around a little bit here, but it was one day on this. Let's go ahead and give it that one day.
Welcome to the Resistance.
Long live the Resistance!
Yes, long live it. Actually, we don't want it to live very long, do we? Because we want it to succeed, and therefore end, and then move into normal life. Alright, East Asia stands ready to help XCOM, so we get additional income.
New regional contacts located.
And additional contacts. Cool. Alright, so the fire axis scientist is 4 days. We've got a supply drop in 2 days.
Avenger plotting new course.
And the Avatar project, whatever that is underway.
Got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
It's gonna be that one guy, the smoker.
I had high hopes for the Resistance under your leadership, Commander. And you have outdone yourself.
Well, really? Thank you. Alright, so our monthly supply income is 200. I think he's telling us we've got a recruit new staff at Resistance Headquarters. Great. Uh-oh. dark events. We have received intel regarding the alien current activities. Preparation to foil these dark events before they can be enacted are already underway. Counter operations will be available soon. So this takes 20 intel for a hidden event. I'm not sure what to do with these. Let's go ahead and thank you very much for that. Supply drop. A hidden resource cache is available to us. Once we travel there, we can collect the supplies. Okay, great. Let's ignore that for now, though. It's going to take 3 days to get it. I want to get the scientist so we can get cracking on more intel. Hopefully it's intel to make a vibe. Launching that intel. Command of the Resistance Council has new high-priority missions information. That's the thing. Alright. 100 intel. That's what we want. Operation Hammer Wagon. Alright. So we are going to move into Operation Hammer Wagon. And now...
Setting course for India.
So we've got one sniper. This is our grenadier. Let's see if we get a promotion for her. We want to go with Shredder. And while we're at it, let's see if we can upgrade her gun. Kevlar armor, not bad.
Ranger deploy.
Squad green to deploy.
Operation Hammer Wagon.
The spokesman has confirmed the location of a VIP valuable to the alien cause moving in this area, and he's asked that we use this opportunity to neutralize the operative. Secure the surrounding area and remove all enemy security forces guarding the target. Bring him in alive if possible, dead if necessary.
Seeing as I haven't yet learned how to incapacitate an enemy, it might be dead.
Menace 1-5, target location confirmed. Move to engage. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Alright, that looks
our
like
position is masked.
This is the evac location, and that's where we need to go. Alright, so...
On the move!
Our gremlins can attempt to access the ADMET network from here. We might be able to hack their systems and get an advantage. But be careful. If they detect us, things will only get worse.
Alright, so a gamble.
Will do. Enemy squad located.
There now. Overwatch.
I hate those brain melders. These little insectoid guys can. I guess this is. Yeah, we could get a 89% shot on this guy. We've got the sniper rifle. Let's go ahead and pew pew that guy. What's this? Long watch concealed. Fire on first enemy that moves within your line of sight and squad sight range, but only if you are real. Okay, so we aren't revealed yet. But let's go ahead and take this target out, we say.
We've been spotted!
I'm spotted.
Want that insectoid guy dead. 64% chance. I think I can move here.
Moving on target location.
That gets me closer to the target.
We found the mark.
Target identity confirmed. Menace 1-5. Remember, we're here to capture the VIP if possible.
All right,
knock them out and bring them in.
How we capture them. Capture the VIP, move a soldier to close range and use the subdue ability, and then carry the unconscious VIP to the evac. So we'll go for capturing them. I'm going to go ahead and finish off this turkey. If we can.
Hostile neutralized.
Alright. We've got a slash option here, so let's move in and attack.
Taken care of. Well, would you look at that?
Nice goodies.
Tech guys will love this.
Alright, let's rush over there.
Moving out. Good copy. Moving on target.
Some Overwatch.
Moving to Overwatch.
Close proximity range. You might be a runner. That door is already open.
Forces on the ground.
So that target's going to come in through that door.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Go ahead and set up Overwatch.
Moving to Overwatch.
What the flip happened to these guys? See that? They went sliding down the stairwell.
What's going on?
Disoriented. I guess he demolished the stairs.
No!
Good thing. I'm taking fire!
Okay then.
Alright, so let's get an open shot.
On my way!
This target is 95%. Let's go ahead and take it out. He used a shotgun through the window and didn't hit his partner. Okay, so can take out this target, 89% chance.
Nailed him. Running dry.
Menace 15, be advised. Hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position. Firebrand has a limited window to provide extraction.
Okay, so how do I get up here?
10-4.
That's how.
Got it.
Getting it done.
And we got stairs here as well, so let's try going up these stairs.
Moving out.
Extraction points over here, and to get onto the roof, I think we still need to get outside. There's a grate here, so let's go ahead and get.
Got it!
If necessary, I think I can drop down from the top here. I think that's a window in.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Affirmative. Moving out.
Let's see if we get the option. I guess not. So let's make it up onto the platform.
Position confirmed.
If need be, we can go down and in. Being the sniper, let's go ahead and reload.
Back in!
Understood. Moving out.
Come get some! Position confirmed.
Man.
So I'm still on the floor below this turkey, so that did nothing to help me here.
I'm on the move.
Back on the roof, pal. Get back on the roof. Break those windows. No windows shall be safe with you. All right, let's subdue this guy. You're gonna get punched out.
Status confirmed. Target package in custody.
We've got the target in custody. Closing on target position now.
She's gonna climb up the ladder carrying that guy. She's a brute.
Enemy's moving on our position.
Menace 1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
Rolling out!
Headed there now. Got it covered. Got it.
Solid copy.
That's right, making you climb your way out. Upstairs. Give you the long watch.
Got it covered.
And we'll get down over here because we need to have somebody covering.
Heading out
on the extraction point. Don't want to extract just yet.
Got it.
What? Okay. Get him out of there.
VIP secure and in position for evac. This is Firebrand. VIP is secure.
Ongoing!
Menace 1-5, hostile interceptors are on high-speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
Just in time!
Okay. Right,
and we are out of here. Oh. Oh boy. Well, damn.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Well, we got our sniper killed. I didn't realize they could shoot through the ceiling there. Goodness gracious, they got her. They wiped her out. Well, there's no coming back for that woman. Well, there was some foreshadowing, if you get what I'm talking about, but yeah, that seat will be empty. No sniper made it back. They don't seem too torn up about it, though. Operation Hammer Wagon. Got a scientist, lost a sniper. I tell you what, shooting through ceilings is something else. I wonder if I could have gone around a little further out and had no problems. Shoot her down. She had four missions, too. All right. Mr. Jack Wilson.
Hello, Commander.
All right, so we've done the Resistance a great service for bringing back the Advent VIP alive, allowing us to gain some important intel. So we got our intel 100. That's going to give us what we need to reach out. Supply drops available. That's good to know. Firefight. Not now. Good, make the contact.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Really?
Attempting to establish local regional contact.
Commander, we've received word that the aliens have completed a facility devoted to their work on the Avatar project. If we can establish contact with the local resistance forces in this region, we can make a move on that facility and destroy it to set back the aliens' operation.
Okay. We must make contact with local resistance in this region before we can infiltrate and destroy this facility. Alright. We'll get there. Calm down. Still trying to deal with the loss of that sniper. That was harsh. Alright, so what do we got? We've got unstaffed engineer and a power at capacity. So let's get
Commander, I appreciate you recruiting new staff for the engineering team, but as it stands, we have people still waiting for an assignment. We can have them working on construction, excavation, or staffing a facility.
Well, I'm working on it, all right? Calm down. Sheesh. Alien debris up here. Let's get somebody to work. Okay. So that's underway. Well, since we've got one day left for the facility proving ground, let's get back to the command and put in a day's time at least here.
The proving grounds are ready, Commander. We can build the Skulljack whenever you give the word.
But now you're going to tell me we don't have an engineer to do the Skulljack, huh?
Welcome to the proving grounds, Commander. It seemed like a good idea to isolate some of our more experimental concepts, especially when it comes to weapons development. I'll have the team get started immediately, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as we've made progress.
Okay, so we're working on that. No more red indicators down there. That's pretty key. That helps you out in understanding whether you got something missing. 2 days left for magnetic weapons. Didn't I buy the tech for magnetic weapons? Well, I should have freed that up. So we're completing the Skulljack project in progress. We're making contact with the West Asia. And we gotta do that.
And then, so Skulljack coming up.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
Yeah, but
these
magnetic-based
weapons
so.
Are a lot like the early railgun prototypes. They fire projectiles at extremely high velocity.
Not bad. Alright, so we've got our magnetic weapons. It allows for magnetic rifle, shard gun, mag pistol, and gauze weapons. Boom, 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 boom. And 6-8 autopsy is now instant. Yep, okay. Great, so we're gonna do this instant research.
The Advent Stun Lancer was apparently outfitted with the intention of serving as a civilian peacekeeping unit within the city centers. Although they are equipped with weapons capable of administering non-lethal blows, recent reports indicate an increasingly aggressive stance taken by these units.
He likes getting his hands dirty and talking about it, don't he?
Although Advent clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers, it seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
Alright, we got an arc blade. New research. What do we want to do here? Sectoid, if it's instant.
Though
why
I
not?
Was never witness to one myself, countless observers attest to the existence of a much smaller, less intimidating variant of the sectoid that took part in the original invasion. In the time since, this new being, the product of clear genetic manipulation, is now a familiar face to our forces operating in the field. Sectoid's rapid physical evolution over the past 20 years is a testament to both the aliens' mastery of genetic engineering and their pursuit of advancement, regardless of the risks.
Alright, so we got a mind shield. Now that might be nice to get. Anything else quick? We can do the faceless. That's 3 days. Psionics. And I think I want gauze weapons, though. Now, I thought I have gauze weapons, though, don't I? Didn't I just get... If I buy it, why am I having to still learn it? I don't know.
I am at a loss for words to describe the difficulties we have had in attempting to handle this creature, affectionately known as the Faceless, to our troops. The nebulous form of its physical structure, including a pliable, semi-solid outer layer, seems to be slowly degrading now that the creature has expired. There is also a pungent odor that only seems to grow stronger as time passes. The aliens have considerable resources at their disposal, but we've still managed to do reasonably well against them, despite our own limitations.
Okay, so we have resistance comms.
We're picking
capacity.
Up an unsecured transmission from some clown calling himself Van Dorn. Doesn't sound like the kind of recruit we're looking for.
What can I do for you, Commander?
I would like to improve my communications. And I don't know that we have that done yet. Guerrilla tactics. Can build some items. There's a battle scanner, flashbang grenades, med kits are nice, mind shield, smoke grenade, cool. Weapons, the shard gun. Wow, this is gonna take a lot of supplies to get these guys outfitted. Nanoscale, 2 Advent Trooper Corpses, 30 supplies, instant. I'm all for getting armor. And down to 176 supplies. I really do want to get that communications up before I use everything up. Command.
I've been digging through some of the old data files Central has been holding on to since before the war. I keep running across notes scrawled in English and what looks like broken German. I should probably ask him about it. Hello, Commander.
Hello, Commander. Work is well underway, but it will be some time yet before my research is complete.
Okay, I'm not seeing anything to increase the comms. I did it once. Not certain. What is this site? Commander's quarters? Nope. Research, we're doing that. We got the engineering, bar memorial, armory. Yeah, not seeing it right now. The contacts, we got 3 of 3, and we're working on making contact with West Asia. Alright, so I think we're going to hold off for now. We've got some training going on, we've got some research, building out some additional rooms. We'll pause it for now. We had quite a costly gain of intel, and it looks like we've used up some of it. We're down to 76. Well, this is PapaSean. We are looking at XCOM 2. This is the Avenger. We built it out quite a bit, and we'll stop here. It's 3 a.m. Gonna take a break. All right, get some sleep. Well, thank you. Share, like, subscribe. It would help me out greatly, and I will catch you in the next episode. It's free to do all those things, and you can gather up additional videos and check out channels. You'll also be notified when content's made available. Thanks again. Later.